Welcome back. You have thousands of work items. Think about it as threads executing in parallel on your GPU or any other accelerator. Your GPU can sometimes run hundreds of thousands of work items per clock cycle. Mapping these threads or work items to the hardware resources has huge performance implications. Let's talk about subgroups and how to boost your performance even further. Check out my other video on ND range, where I demonstrate how the locality of the work items matters a lot. This, for example, is the structure of my Iris XELP GPU. The basic building block is an execution unit. A subslice contains 16 such execution units and some other logics. And in my GPU, there are 6 subslices that construct one slice. Work items running on different subslices will have to communicate via the L3 cache, so I can define a work group. A work group of 64, for example, means that each 64 of my work items, of my threads, will run on the same subslice and can communicate via the SLM and have the same thread dispatch and so on, which is great, but we can do even more. Work items running on the same EU can communicate via registers and utilize some of the hardware inside of the same EU to perform all kinds of operations between them, locally and faster. So all the work items in a subgroup can perform all kinds of shuffle operations between them. You can find the list of group operations in the SYCL documentation. It could be select specific item, shift, permute, and more. And yes, these operations will be done inside the same EU using the local EU memory and hardware, so as fast as the GPU can execute. Let me show you a quick example. Subgroups can only have certain possible sizes. Let's take a queue, print its name, look for the possible subgroup sizes and print them. Compile and run, and you can see that we can have subgroups of 8, 16, or 32 for this device. Now let's check what is my subgroup size. I'm going to print the subgroup size from the kernel. GPUs cannot usually do that, so I'll use this command, SQL stream, and you can see here the out command. Compile and run, and my subgroup size is 16. There is a way to force the size. So I have here the global size, the work group size, and I'm forcing the subgroup size to be 8. This is hardware and vendor specific. So you can see here the Intel. And I'm going to print it out. Compile and run. And yes, subgroup size is 8. And let's use it. I'm iterating n times with workgroup size of B, and I'm forcing the subgroup to be 32. And for each subgroup, I'm using reduce over group, basically accumulating all the data handled by the subgroup into result. And I will store the result in the first element and print it out. Compile and run, and you can see that any 32 elements of the data were reduced, summarized, into the first element. And it's all been done inside the EU. Now let's change the subgroup to 8. Compile and run. And you can see that now every 8 elements were reduced into the first one. Pretty cool. So, subgroups can help you further improve the performance of your code. Lots of training materials and examples. Take a look at the code snippets at the link below, or just look at the oneAPI samples on GitHub. Enjoy, subscribe, thank you.